Yeah, it's two close, tough ones at home against two pretty fair sides, I suppose. Yeah, they both played finals last year. And, yeah, it's tough, but competing very well, as St. George are and as Penrith are. We just got to try and finish it off.
How do you think your side handled it, particularly when it was close late in the match?
Oh, look, there's certainly going to be things for us to look at there, as there will be probably for the third golden point on the weekend. There's a lot of players, with the referees not blowing penalties and the game fast. There's a lot of tired people on the field. And we had a couple of goes, and Saints had a few goes. And when you win them, you're happy, and when you lose them, you're disappointed. But there's some areas that certainly that I'm sure that all the sides that didn't quite get it right to look at and think we could have done a little bit better. You know, we're in the same boat as them.
I think Pissy had three or four. Did you want
Kalen
to have a shot?
I'd probably think Mason would probably be an option. Kalen, I'm sure he can kick him, but. We've got a few things here we can look at, as Corey Norman missed a couple and Ben Hunt missed a couple, and they just end up nailing one, So it's but there's certainly one or two things we can look at in the back period of the game, which I'm sure St. George, if we'd kicked the one of ours men over, St. George would probably say the same thing.
You happy with your fullback?
Look, he had some really, really good periods in the game, didn't he? He had some really, really good periods, and he'll learn some stuff from the back period of the game as well. It was tight, and if the refs keep doing what they're doing, we're going to see a lot of tired people and a lot of tight situations, we can just all look back, and there'll be players, as I said, there'll be plenty of sides over the weekend that'll think there'll be little periods in that back 10 minutes of the game. There's a lot of tired bodies on the field. How all sides handle that, I suppose, a lot of clubs will be looking at it.
Randy, are you happy for the refs to keep officiating the way they're officiating with the 10 metres?
If they're going to consistently do it, and we all know about it. My thing with it is, if that's how it's going to be ref, that's fine, as long as we keep doing it and then there's not a knee-jerk reaction to people complaining about it, So if they're going to keep refing it consistently both ways, I'm not sure anyone should complain about it. But as I said, there's a lot of tired people on the field, and it sort of makes for an interesting periods of the game. It's probably when they do decide to blow it. We probably got the raw end of the stick, the James Graham threw a flick pass and we got penalised for it, so then we stayed on the ball and then we got penalised for it. So that's where they will get themselves into trouble, if they just come up with some that are not really needed. If they're going to let it flow.
What do you think of Mason Leno?
Mason was certainly coming to the game underdone. He's had limited footage due to an injury, but I thought he was nice and solid, especially his defensive part of the game was really strong. He had Tarek coming at him, and Tarek's, in his last, 16 months of footy, Tarek has proved as hard to handle as anyone on the edge. So he'd got that part really, really well. But we certainly need to help him get in the game a bit more, and he needs to help himself get in the game a bit more, the risk with Kalen back at six is it gets too left-sided dominant, So we need to make sure our right-sided player gets himself in the contest a bit as well. But as a whole, as I said, he really handled Tarek well, and he came up pretty solid.
Do you think he gets a bit of an extended run in the team now?
I'm not a big fan of changing halves, to be honest with you. So, look, he's certainly got the skill set to help the team improve. There's no doubt about that. And with more footy and more match fitness, I'm sure he'll keep improving.
And where does that leave Connor Watson, and if he's fit next
week? Connor can play numbers of positions, and I'm not sure if Connor's going to be fit yet. So if he is going to be fit, then we'll have some decisions to make. Connor's good at dummy half, and Kurt's good in the centres, and so they are handy players, and the game, if we do keep getting these tired people on the field, people like Connor become very important with their speed.
Randy, you've been critical a little bit of the team's effort sort of in the last couple of games. You couldn't fault that tonight.
Oh, yeah, it was tremendous, I thought, tonight, and even against Penrith, going down 16-14, against Penrith, we probably weren't quite as good as we were the week before against Cronulla, but I don't think anyone would be critical of. There's a lot of St. George as well. If we'd got the field goal, I don't think St. George would be critical of their effort either. So the challenge now is we've got to back up against Manly and come out and put in a good one on on Saturday. Yeah, it's going to be a good challenge. Boys get themselves back up and come and put a good one in against Manly, who are playing some good footy.
How deflating is it for the team, for the players, to get beat like that?
Well, there's always deflation for that losing side, isn't there? The emotion of sport. It's not a great thing at times, I suppose, when you're the losing one, but they should also get a lot of thrill out of the fact that, you know, St. George got two tries. One was from a strip. So the fact that, you know, the area where we did put a lot more work into appears to be holding up for us and holding up under pressure against good players. So the fact that, you know, that first 4 weeks of football, you know, I'm not sure where we sit defensively, but we're only a bit over two tries a game, which is certainly hadn't been a common trait for a Newcastle Knight side for a lot of years. So if we can maintain that and keep that going and just, you know, tidy up one or two things, keep trying to improve a little bit. Yeah, as I said, as we saw over the weekend, a lot of sides had a lot of tired people and a lot sort of at times found it tough to get the combinations and score.
Thank you.